I'm here, idiots.
Hey, what up? It's the On Air Idiot Show. Big man, Kenny Douglas's. Got Raekwon, the chef, right here, man.
Oh, man.
About to do Toad's Place Underground Jam 5.
And they're ready for him, man. They're ready for him out there.
Five.
You know what I mean? And listen, it's all love. We're going to have a good time tonight. We got a few surprises. We got a surprise DJ tonight.
Oh, shit.
Special guest DJ tonight.
Yeah, you're gonna see that nigga.
Hey,
yo, it was so ironic. I'm sitting here, we doing the listen shit. And I'm like, damn, I need a fucking DJ. And look who walked in the door.
Big man is here to save the day, man.
All day. He always here for us. We always get together. We're going to turn it up tonight. It's going to be real serious. What's up, my brother?
What up, man? What's up with the project, man? The
project is vicious right now. Okay. It's done. You know what I mean? I just closed my deal. You the first one to know that I signed with EMI right now.
Okay. So that's news?
The first man.
That's news? Tell them that's news, yeah, right? That's news, man.
That's real news. Real talk. I just signed off yesterday. You know what I mean? Made everything official. So EMI is the home right now. They the ones that's paying me. They gave me a nice piece of what I needed, though.
Okay.
You know,
that's what it is. Okay.
Good. All right.
There gonna be a lot of ghosts on the record as well, on the project?
Ghosts gonna be up there, you know what I mean? But at the end of the day, it's gonna be raw hip hop, B. You know what I mean? I try to tell a lot of people, don't really get caught up into what you may love. Just get caught up into real hip hop.
Right.
You know what I mean? When I made this album, I made it to be a classic. I didn't look at it as having ghosts all the way through it like that, because it don't make it special. And, you know what I mean? I don't give other brothers a shot.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? We made the first one. Ghost just was happening to be constantly near everything.
Man.
This one, you can't make one like two. So, you know, just open your eyes, though, but I'm going to keep it right.
Yeah.
We're going to keep it where we supposed to keep it.
Yeah.
And at the end of the day, that's what I think I've done.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? My team, you know what I mean? My administration crew, they've been holding me down, making sure that I stay focused, you know what I mean? Doing shows. We here with y'all, we gonna get it in. But that album, this shit is better than your mama's spaghetti, man.
Listen, man. Now let's talk hip hop. Let's talk hip hop right now. You know what I mean? Cause a lot of people say, some people say it's dead, some people say it's like it's sort of the ringtone rap. How do you feel about it? Cause, you know, my personal thing is, I think people are buying into the image more than they're buying into the lyricist itself.
Absolutely. Creativity is gone. You know what I mean? Artistry is gone. So it's cosmetic right now. On a wide scale. You know what I'm saying? But on a scale of real news, really love hip hop, it's always a piece of that shit around.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? That's why you got to set yourself. You know, certain legends in the game that have been in it for 10, 12 years that still you can hear right now.
Yeah, right.
They holding weight with what's going on right now.
Right.
Spanking them, but they just don't get the airplay.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? But that's only you, and it's only you as an individual that loves hip hop that much that never will forget that side of it.
I personally think that it's there's a problem between the record labels and the radio.
Of course.
The radio is the middleman between the record labels and the people.
Right.
You know? And then, for some reason, I don't know where it all changed, but it was different when 36 Chambers came out.
Of course. Because
and now it's totally different.
Because you know what? At that time when radio was popping off, they didn't have nothing.
Yeah.
We gave them something, and they seen how the people was responding, and they let us, it's like letting a bunch of motherfuckers run through the door, because they so deep, it's like, let them niggas in, all of them, you know what I mean? Now they got a certain kind of lock on it, where politics and money and relationships down the line make sure shit is straight for, for the future, you know what I mean? I don't want to throw no names out there, but it was niggas that paid to make sure that you're holding me down. Hold me down. So now it ain't about the hip hop. It's about, oh, that nigga came in with that motherfucking mean ass watch. You know what I mean? 10 bottles of champagne. You know what I mean? That congratulations shit. And that started to stir the heads of the DJs, the programmers, of thinking that, okay, we're superstars too now. take away from the art of it. That was the best way to do it.
Yeah.
But we all know money will tear us up.
Yeah. Yeah, well, what was the thought process between with the a lot of the Wu-Tang skits, going back to 36, going back to the double album, a lot of skits. I always wanted to know, like, you guys would have a long skit before a song.
Right.
Was that planned, or was that you guys just kicking it in the studio? What was that?
It was always planned, because when you get us on wax, you gotta get everything.
Yeah.
You gotta get the funny shit. You gotta get the whatever we felt at that time shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And plus, I like my CDs like that. I like to, you know what I mean? It's like an interlude on an album or R&B album, whatever. It's just our way of just taking a break real quick to really get back to the music, but still take your mind somewhere else.
Yeah.
It's like snapping. You know what I mean? We constantly around me as a joker, so why not let that funny shit fly to make you loosen up off with a rhyme real quick and, you know, bug out for a minute.
Yeah, yeah.
Torture skin.
Yeah.
I fucking, you know what I mean? Make you think of your niggas in the hood.
Right, right, right.
So that's all we was just implementing, is just that. That's
okay.
All.
No doubt. Now, going back to what we were talking about with the hip hop thing, how did that keep you? Just knowing how the game has changed and how the attitude and the mentality behind it, how do you keep your motivation and how do you keep going with it? You know what I'm saying? Because some people might lose that passion just knowing, man, like, I'm not trying to go down that road, man. You know what I'm saying? Dudes is paying to get their songs played. Dudes is looking at, you know, if I don't come in with like $50,000 worth of jewelry around my neck, you know what I mean? $50,000 on the wrist or whatever, they gonna think I'm a fraud. How do you keep yourself motivated with that?
You know, I don't give a fuck. I don't care about all that.
Right.
Cause I already, it's like a nigga that already said, yo, I'ma take this $500 pack of crack, and tomorrow I'ma buy me a brick.
Right.
That's what I've done already.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So nobody can ever take that away from me. Now it's on me to initiate who I am more now, because I'm realizing that I'm a veteran now.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? Sometimes being a legend is a gift and a curse, because a legend is something that came and went to somebody. But to me, a legend is somebody who made it. Then it's up to the individual to see if he really still wants this, you know?
Right.
I love this. I live this. I walk down the street the same way the next man walk. I know how to get flashy and get on some real shit, and I know how to be humble and be respectful and walk again across the street. That's just being a man.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? But I'm very grounded. I think it's just about being grounded. Don't worry about none of that, B. I know I get busy. I know I still ain't G-off yet. Personally, me, four albums ain't nothing. I need 40 to get my point across. But I'm a soldier to the womb, which I always been, so that took a lot of my time to really G off. But I still have so much to offer, and I'm right here with the people. I can't make the young ones really understand it that much, because they may not know what I'm about, but I still got my people who love me.
It's all about that core fan.
Yeah, I gotta stick to
that's the foundation.
I gotta stick to my brand and whatever it's gonna be.
Since we're in Connecticut, can you explain to the people East Connecticut line?
East Connecticut was basically me just thinking about y'all, just, you know what I mean, just your state happened to be on my mind, you know what I mean? I got family out there, I know a lot of people out there, you know what I mean? I had good homeboys out there. Shout out my nigga Chuck, I don't know where you at, hope you ain't under the wall or nothing, or, you know what I mean, real good friends out there. So at that time it was like, yo, it was a natural reaction in the mind. I love it.
What's next for the chef, man?
Fire, man. You know what I mean? We got a lot of things going on. The album is coming, you know what I mean? It's summer. Get ready. I got a movie I'm working on. And I sat down and I wrote and I really crafted. This is some real bioptical shit that motherfuckers is gonna see. You know what I'm saying? It's like, just get ready, dude, for real, man. I got a lot to prove right now.
Word. That's what it is.
Legendary status right here.
Get caught up in nothing else but making sure I paint this picture for y'all.
Damn.
Straight up.
It's about time to hit that stage.
Dad.
I'm gonna go get set up.
Yeah.
We about to get real live out here.
Yeah.
All right.
Wheels.
No doubt. We about to go get real live. Okay. Watch how we do this.
Make sure the mics is crisp.
We'll have some fun tonight.
Black man, Wu-Tang Clan, smacking.
Yeah.
Fronting. Chill. Chill. Cooling. I said cooling, schooling. Everything around me. Might fire one off your clicks around me. I won't stand it, hand it, murder the planet. I'm more like Osama and my coat just landed. You know it, get money nigga, the fly poet who only write rhymes. Then the track exploded, go in.
Idiots.